giving me life, giving me all of you. Oh, it's true. Losing myself, I found me right next to you. Oh, yeah. You're something
about the company. Hannah is going to give a summary on the beginnings of Anthropologie and the purpose the brand was founded on.
For our project, our group decided to analyze Anthropologie, which is one of six sister sub-companies under the Urban Companies franchise. So how did Anthropologie get its start? Dick Hain is the founder, and one of his good girlfriends suggested to him an issue that she was having. She had recently moved to Philadelphia and had no sort of home and clothing store all in one. He then started to realize that that was a very common issue between women everywhere, not just in that one particular place. Upon realizing this issue, Hain's solution was to create a lifestyle store that encompassed beauty, home, and clothing items all into one place. After its grand opening in 1992, Anthropologie has over 200 different stores worldwide, and it steadily prides itself on being an individual portal of discovery for each of its customers, and not just a place where you go shop and then leave.
Business and product and service architecture. Thomas will now give an overview of the strategy, vision, and mission of Anthropologie, and at the same time give an overview of the product and services Anthropologie provides.
Anthropologie is a brand for the creative-minded woman who holds a sense of adventure and style in what she wears during her day-to-day activities, no matter the place or occasion. In order to cater to this particular individual, Anthropologie's vision is to create uniqueness and personalization through a shopping experience that matches each customer's own style and the occasion in which she is dressing for. Their mission is simple. They wish to serve as the stylistic compass that outfits, guides, and empowers women throughout their voyage of life. Competing in a crowded retail market, selling high-end home decor, apparel, and accessories, Anthropologie must set itself apart from the competition in order to maintain their target demographic of women aged 25 to 42. Through outstanding customer service and unique styling, the firm is able to separate itself from the likes of Madewell, J. Crew, Pottery Barn, and others. When the customer first enters the store, they are greeted by a beautiful, vibrant layout and an extravagant display created in-house. Associates then greet the customer, gauging their sense of style and personality. Through gauging the customer's preferences and needs, employees are able to successfully complete an outfit or fulfill any other request. It is through this personalized experience, coupled with a beautiful and trendy store aesthetic, that Anthropologie maintains a strong foothold in the retail industry. Thank you.
Process architecture. Next, Sarah and Hannah give an overview of the mission and non-mission critical processes of the company at the store level.
The mission critical process for Anthropologie involves its POS system, which is directly linked to its servers. If either of these processes go down, sales cannot be made. And if sales cannot be made, revenue is not generated. So this is a mission critical process. The POS system is where purchases are made, where returns are made, where someone can come into the store and order something online, directly affecting revenue.
There are a few non-mission critical processes within Anthropologie. The first is the restock gap, which is simply restocking the floor after sales. The second is AOA, or an order away, which is shipping off merchandise from that store to fulfill online purchases. And the third is the online return system, which is where a customer can return something purchased online to that store, but it won't directly affect that particular store's sales, but company-wide sales.
Data and information architecture. Madison is next going to explain how data is collected and flows through the organization.
Data and information architecture. It mainly has two parts. First, the data architecture part, and that's the process of collecting and storing the data. The next part is the information architecture part, and that's the process of using this data to create information that is useful in making good business decisions. So how does this all work? At Anthropologie, they have mobile devices and desktops where they have Oracle POS system. They're able to make their purchases on here, and they're able to send that information to the on-site server and then to the home office server. where it's stored, where most of the information is stored, but the financial information is stored on the Oracle Cloud server. What they're able to then do with this information is make some smart business decisions. The day-to-day business decisions are best described by Laura Graham, the previous store brand manager. Let's take a look and see what she has to say.
Can you elaborate any more on how you apply this data to decision making or anything like that?
Well,
there's two different ways. Yeah. One of them is like merchandising. And so making sure if it's something that say we sold out of a top and it did really well, what's the next best thing? So what tops is gonna be kind of similar enough to it to where we're gonna have that same result. Mm-hmm. Or if something's really underperforming and say it's doing really well for company but not for us, and I mean, like, why aren't we selling it? Do we know how it fits? Is it something that maybe it's hidden in a spot? So how can we really get behind it? And then how do we want to like focus and sell it? So is there something that we really need to like get behind, like fit sessions, or maybe not with a specific product, but just kind of looking at different other like key performance indicators? Is it something that maybe we're not selling complete outfits? Maybe we're just selling tops, and you know, what about bottoms? Like, gotta have like a complete look, how are we adding on accessories, or like what else are we missing, or maybe we are missing or meeting our expectation, but how can we continue to push it? How can we exceed it?
Another two types of information that's collected by Anthropologie that's important to mention is one, their inventory information, and two, their customer information. First, their inventory information is started out at the beginning of the year by one giant count of inventory. That's then compared with all of the inventory information that's collected through the POS system and stored on the servers, where they're able to keep track of how much they have of something, how much they're missing of certain things, so that they know what's stolen and what might have been just misplaced. They're also able to use that information to know how much they're selling of something, what products are doing really well, and what products are staying on the shelves. So another type of information that's stored is customer information. Through their Anthro Perks program, which is a customer loyalty program, they're able to collect and store customer information. Everything from past purchases, they're able to keep their receipts, so if, say, the person loses their receipt, they're still able to return stuff. They're also able to keep their email, their shipping and billing address, so that makes for easier in-store online purchases. And the data is also used by the allocation teams. These allocation teams are able to use past customer purchasing data to see which specific locations need which specific outfits and jewelry and accessories. So they're able to use this information to meet the needs of their specific clientele at those stores.
Systems and application architecture. Sarah will next describe the systems and applications used by Anthropologie to contain, access, and utilize the information collected.
Anthropologie uses web services and software applications that provide a functional capability for the organization. The intranet is a web service that allows employees to access the POS system and perform work within it. There are many software applications designed specifically for Urban Incorporated for Apple mobile devices. These include the Restock app, AOA, which is an order away, RF, the receiving app, Markdown, Threads, and Kronos. Anthropologie uses two dashboards, a live sales app, as well as the EDW dashboard, where they can pull historic data as well as live data on the daily, weekly, or monthly.
Network and infrastructure architecture. Michael will now explain the network and infrastructure used at the store. The next slide shows a visual of our network documentation, and following is Michael's interpretation of it.
So Anthropologie's network makes use of a star topology. They have a switch at the center of everything, so that's going to be the point of access for every other device. Now that we've talked about the switch, they are also making use of a switch backbone along with a routed backbone, because the store runs Wi-Fi and Ethernet. So as far as how the entire network diagram actually works is, so there are going to be four desktops in the front of the store. These are going to be their point of transaction for like all their in-store purchases. All these desktops run the Oracle POS system software. The Oracle software is basically just a cloud-based software that keeps track of all their financial transactions. So any sort of like financial transactions that happen within the store, any of the numbers, all that data is stored within their Oracle system. Now, because the Oracle software is only a financial database, stuff like inventory and things like that all get stored within their own intranet server, which they refer to as home office. So whenever transactions happen in the front of the store at the desktops, the data for those numbers gets stored in Oracle, but the actual inventory, that data is sent to the intranet server because they're all connected via switch. Now, the desktops are wired, so they have Ethernet cables running into them, which eventually lead back into their telecommunications closet or network closet, which contains this switch. Each store also has a set of mobile devices that are specifically used for monitoring anything that happens over their apps. These would obviously need to be connected via Wi-Fi. So for that purpose, there is a router set up in each store that's connected to the switch, which then hosts a wireless AP, which allows for Wi-Fi access. So the wireless AP is again connected via Ethernet cable to the router, which is connected via another Ethernet cable running back to the switch. So internet runs to this entire diagram, basically first reaching the router. So it has to pass the firewall, which keeps any external threats out from reaching Anthropology's private intranet server. Once it's past the firewall, it gets to the router, which is then connected to the switch. So this main route right here basically gives the entire store access to the internet. So because each Anthropology store handles online purchases in store, which basically means whenever someone buys something online, they will deliver it from a certain store to that person. So they're notified because they're able to check on their mobile devices in store. Now the data for this needs to still reach the internet and the Oracle POS software, which it's able to do because it's connected to the AP, which then that data runs to the router into the switch, which can direct it to either the internet server, which would be for inventory, or the Oracle POS software, which would just handle the financial numbers.
Assessment of the network and enterprise architecture. Allie will next give an overview of our assessment of the network and enterprise architecture of Anthropology.
Anthropology has a clear issue with their social alignment. Local store managers and associates have a general understanding of how IT is used and applied in the workspace, but that understanding is limited, preventing them from articulating the flow of information. We saw three main issues that we believe Anthropology could address to improve their social alignment. First, Laura directly addresses an issue that she experienced as a local store manager.
What overall problems do you encounter with any of the information architecture that we've talked about so far? Or are there any things that work particularly well within the architecture?
I
think one thing that it's not hard, there's a lot of information, which is great, but it's all in different spots.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's in emails, sometimes it's through a conference call, sometimes it's in our intranet, and I think that it's hard to make sure that you're could be full-time just reading everything and educating yourself on it and making sure that you're taking all that and doing something with it and making sure that there it doesn't just kind of hit at you. I think that's the hardest part, which again, it's nice because I have all this information to do anything I can with it and really impact it, to where it's not they're just giving me a little snippet and they say, okay, go, this is all you need to know right now, that I have all this information that I can really impact to the most of my ability.
The second thing that we saw that Anthropology could improve is their slow wireless internet connections during busy periods. Adding another access point would allow associates to get their day-to-day tasks done quicker so that they can focus their attention on the customers in store. The third critique that we saw is that Anthropology could create a better sense of communication and transparency between management and store associates. Store associates spend most of their time on the floor, so having a great understanding of the information that is used to create the environment that they're in will allow associates to better serve the customers.
Solving the challenge. In conclusion, Allie will provide the proposed solutions our team came up with for each critique of the network and enterprise architecture.
To overcome the current network and enterprise architecture in the firm, we would like to propose three solutions to Anthropology. First, they could address the flow of communication. Narrowing down a pathway for information to travel makes it easier to process and communicate that information. Utilizing a single dashboard would be an effective way to address this issue. To address the second issue, as we mentioned earlier, adding an additional access point as well as updating to fiber optics would improve the speed of the wireless network. To address the third critique, management can post weekly reports that outline the following. First, a weekly sales report so that associates are aware of weekly sales goals and performance. Second, a weekly marketing report informing employees of initiatives that they can focus on for the week. And finally, key performance indicators to reiterate those goals and initiatives. These three reports open up a line of communication between management and associates.
I know it's cliche, I swear you're changing my life.